Lazarus was dead. Not even passionate Paul. Not even disciplined Wesley. Not even scholarly Calvin or reforming Luther. Not even careful Jonathan Edwards. Not even Frederick Douglass. Not the dreamer Martin Luther King Jr. Not studious William Miller. Not visionary Ellen G. White. Not even your past pastor, Pastor Goodman, or your future pastor, Pastor Johns. In verse 4, he weeps for them, but he also weeps for us. For if I could confess, too many times I've been more concerned with what the saints think than what Jesus thinks. Too many times I've been nicer to others than I've been nicer to my own family. Too many times I've been more concerned about public reputation than godly spirituality. Too many times I've been more concerned with my next church assignment than church mission. I acted without prayer, run ahead of the angels. I'm somebody who has fallen, but got back up again. One of the elders said to John in John 5:5, weep not. Don't weep, John. There is somebody who is qualified. He's from the line, he's the lion of the tribe of Judah. He is worthy. And Jesus now steps into the picture. Jesus enters into the black night of our experience, not with flashing strobe lights, but through a back door called Bethlehem. Here comes Jesus. Here comes Jesus, not with trumpets and fanfare, larger than life stage smoke and pounding music. Suddenly he comes, a king in disguise. Jesus born to an unwed teen mother on the other side of the tracks. But Jesus was more than a poor baby born of a dirt poor mother, but a baby in a manger who created both heavens and earth. For he spake and it was done. He commanded, it stood fast. The maker of humanity became a human. He, ruler of the stars, might be nourished at the breast. That he, the bread, might be hungry. That he, the fountain, might thirst. That he, the light, might sleep, that he, the way, might be wearied by the journey, that he, the truth, might be accused by false witnesses, that he, the judge of the living and the dead, might be brought to trial by a mortal judge, that he, justice, might be condemned by an unjust judge, that he, discipline, might be scourged with whips, that he, the fountain, might be